work hard for it, Allah did make it for them. Exactly the same way. He did ask Allah day and night to pass away as shaheed in the city of Muhammad. Did he achieve it? Why Allah, if you are asking Allah to be closer to him, why Allah is going to deny your application? Why your application will be declined? If Allah is accepting the application of the disobedient, he's drinking and he's saying, Allah is going to let me this just like, it's going to protect me. He's committing other things and he's saying, it's telling her, don't worry, Allah, we are under the eye of Allah. And Allah is protecting them. And Allah is making them unsubjected to others. What about those who want to put their nose down to Allah? Ya Allah, it's a mess. And I'm not sure what I have to do. Please guide me. Don't let me under the power of my nafs, as Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam used to leave as a dua. Ya Allah, don't let the predominant of my ruling is my nafs. Because my nafs is horrible. As Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam did say, the most enemy, the most dangerous enemy in your life is not the shaitan. Wallahi, is not the shaitan. Shaitan, I'm telling you right now as a grand, shaitan of jinn, you're gonna say, A'udhu billah, and he's running. It doesn't need more than that. وَإِمَّا يَنْزَغَنَّكَ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ نَزْغَ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ. That's it. Tens of shayateen of jinn will come and deal with you. And it's gonna take you, أعوذ بالله. And everything is okay. No one of them is there anymore. The problem are two. Is the nafs, as Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام did say, وَنَفْسُكَ الَّتِي بَيْنَ جَنْبَيْكَ. Your nafs, which is inside your chest. And the second is the shayateen of ins. Shayateen of jinn is going to take you one Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. One A'udhu Billah min ash-shaytan ar-Rajim. And he's not there anymore. Shaytan of ins, the whole Baqarah is not going to move. He's going to stay next to you. He has an agenda. He want to take you somewhere. He's going to keep calling day as a night. Days and nights. He's going to bug. Shaitan of jinn cannot get close to Umar because he has realized that whenever he will come, he will get a reward out of his trial. Then he said, let him deal with his own. That is the time we need to listen to the ahadith of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You are going to look around in the ummah, and that's what we'll have inshaAllah subhanahu wa ta'ala for today, so we can. The only thing that's cooling our hearts down a little bit, when you see Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam describing the situation, wallahi al-azim, as he is walking next to you on the same street in 2011. And you are gonna read the hadith, and that's the hadith that he left 1400 years ago. And he's saying exactly, he is describing how the men will look like, how the women will look like, how Muslims will look like in the Ummah of Islam, how they will, what they will say about their deen, exactly what he said. One of you will come and sit on his sofa. That's what he said, alayhi salatu wasalam, on his sofa. The Prophet saying, a day will come, some of you will sit on their sofa talking about the deen and saying, we will follow only the book of Allah and we have nothing to do with the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Did it happen?
Yes.
And they were on their sofa, as Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam says. Some of you, the Prophet is telling them, they know nothing about the real deen, and they will come saying, oh, the book of Allah is the book that Allah has protected. Sunnah is just like here and there, and just we'll follow only the book of Allah. And the Prophet is telling them, whatever Muhammad has brought is from Allah. And if they want to follow the book of Allah, the book of Allah did say, ما أتاكم الرسول فخذوه وما نهاكم عنه فانتهوا. Whatever Muhammad has brought, you have to take. Whatever Muhammad has stopped, prohibited, you have to stop. Let's live with one of the hadith so we can, because it's hitting, it's, I'm gonna repeat what we used to discuss earlier. I never blame, huh? What I used to say? I never blame the enemies of Islam. I never blame somebody who's doing his job. Allah did say that's his job. They don't like you. Why? If Allah is saying those hearts don't like you, why I'm gonna keep? Why? Why what? Allah did say, ولن ترضى عنك اليهود ولا النصارى حتى تتبع ملتهم. Jews and Christians will never be satisfied with you till you follow them. Simple. Then why you have been, we have been fighting for what? I could understand. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did make it clear. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did make it clear. What we have been talking about? Muhammad alayhi salatu wa salam did make it clear to this ummah. What's wrong? What's wrong? I never blame the enemies of Islam because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given that grant to this ummah. You will only see the problem whenever the problem is in ourselves. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did mention it, reveal it in many of the locations in the Quran and many of the hadith of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam around the same meaning. The way you are, the way they will be. And thus they are the leaders, the rulers. The way you are, the way they will be. You wanna check how they are? Check how you are. Simple. أَيْنَمَا تَكُونُ يُوَلَّ عَلَيْكُمْ. The same you are, the same they will be. You are good, they will be good. You are bad, they will be bad. You will fix, they will be fixed. You will not fix. Because that particular item Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to rule this ummah, Allah has assigned that task to himself. Tools of dunya will be played, will be worked out by Allah to fulfill Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's concept that will never change. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying in one of the verses so we can understand. Whenever Allah wanna destroy a city, they have been disobeying Allah. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is doing? Amarna mutrafiha, we are gonna command. We are gonna command the disobedience of this ummah, of that city. أَمَرْنَا مُتْرَفِيهَا فَفَسَقُوا فِيهَا. So they will misachieve, they will spoil, they will disobey, they will fight against Allah. Allah is sending them as a punishment for those who are ruled. And once Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, once the ummah is changing themselves, Allah is not going to change unless we change ourselves. That's a concept. You change, Allah will change. You fix yourself up, Allah will fix them up. You have disconnected the relationship with Allah, Allah will send the one whose relationship with Allah is disconnected to punish you under the eye of Allah. till you fix yourself up. Let's go to that great hadith of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I think that at the time we need to get like every other, maybe every 2-3 sessions, we need to get what we discussed earlier, the signs of the Day of Judgment, or the signs of the last day, and how almost every single what's called minor and middle sign did happen, and how Muhammad alayhi salatu was salam, the great messenger, whatever you wanna, I'm telling you the details is to an extent that no one can believe it. No one can, during his time, they used to tell him, Ya Rasulullah, we believe in you, but is it gonna happen as such? And he's telling them, Wallahi, worse than that will happen. Worse than that will happen. During his time, he told them, what do you think about not commanding one another with goodness, forbidding one another from evil? They said, Ya Rasulullah, with Muslims, that's in Islamist, that's the criteria of being the best ummah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent. And the Sahaba cannot visualize or think that one day will come and the ummah, the Prophet did not say, the Prophet said, just no command with goodness, no forbid from evil. They said, Ya Rasulullah, that's gonna happen? He said, Wallahi, worse than that will happen. And he told them in the same hadith, what do you think about the time will come that you will command one another with evil, forbid one another from goodness? And he said, what? That's not only stopping the function, that's reversing the whole function and flipping the whole table upside down. And he said, Ya Rasulullah, we know that you are the truthful, but is it gonna happen to this ummah? He said, Wallahi, worse than that will happen. Did it happen? Are you sure? Commanding one another with evil and forbidding one another from goodness? Brother, don't come to Fajr. That's dangerous. Why? It's just like it's gonna spoil your day and just cannot take care of your work. And okay, good. Then, oh, but tonight, there is a, oh man, fantastic party. Are you sure? Yo, see, let me tell you the incentive. What incentives? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, blah, 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 free ticket, blah, 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 blah. It's like Beyonce is coming and just. Commanding one another with evil and spending effort to invite. But what I'm just Fajr, man, don't worry, just everything will be okay. And also Fajr is like, you will be in the blacklist. Praying Fajr is a blacklist. Having hijab and niqab is a blacklist. Commanding one another with goodness, forbidding one another from evil, it's a crime. That's a film. And the Prophet told them, worse than that will happen. And he told them, what do you think about a time it will be the default, that what we know as ma'roof has become the default evil, and what we know as evil has become the default ma'roof? And they said, is it gonna happen, Ya Rasulullah? Did it happen? Did it happen or not? Can you criticize somebody playing music? You are not that civilized man. Can you criticize somebody who has just like one of the bikini or tikini or whatever they want to call it? Can you criticize it? You are an old-fashioned man, just because that has become the ma'roof has become the default munkar. Let me tell you one thing, and that's not even our time. Those corrupted sect of Islam who are insulting Aisha, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshaAllah, either to guide them or take them over, inshallah. During the time